As the saying goes, a free flight in an RV is probably the most expensive flight you'll ever have. So after my free flight, I flew about 35 hours in a nosewheel RV7A and I absolutely loved it. Robin Cos is the unofficial home of superbly built RVs in Cape Town, and one day I sat in the back seat of an RV8 in the hangar, literally in the hangar. I didn't even fly in it, and I knew the RV8 was the plane. Damon from Robin Cos found an RV8 owned by Patrick Handley in Port Alfred. Patrick wasn't getting to fly India Charlie Echo enough. He owns the Mooney and Airvan dealership in South Africa, and his master metalworker Dave Smith built India Charlie Echo from a normal build kit. Not surprisingly, you'll see some Mooney instruments in the panel, making for a gorgeous old school six pack. A while back, I popped in at Port Alfred and met with Dave to show him I was still looking after the plane. I don't know why, I just feel like I'm still just looking after her. India Charlie Echo was registered in 2012 and she had 30 hours on the hobs, so she was practically brand new. Damon did a pre-purchase including blow bars and all the other technical stuff, but my eyes actually focused on his conclusion where Damon said, "Would I be happy to let my children fly in this aircraft? With this aircraft, the answer would be yes." So with the technical stuff sorted, the bit that I didn't really have experience with was actually flying the RV. But I knew Peter Erasmus, he was an instructor, and he took me for a flight, and my logbook says it was on the 21st of June 2014. We flew for about 0.8 hours, and when he came back he said she flew well, so she was the right aircraft. There was a little bit of cracking of the paint on the fiberglass cowl, so that was basically an excuse to look at the paintwork. My son, who was 5 at the time, sat with me and we coloured in some of those profiles. Matt seemed to use quite a bit of orange, which didn't end up using. I had photographed a P-51 Mustang beautiful doll flying at Duxford, and as an RV as an American plane, I thought it was appropriate to pay homage. And the colors were actually gorgeous and worked with the existing blue. So we settled on a design based on beautiful doll. We also included a few little details like my family crest, the Irvins flourish in light and in shade. Yep, it's Scottish. And on the other side, my grandpa Ryan was from Ireland, so my grandpa's come with me every flight. The parts painted were the tail and cowl, which are removable, so there was no tinting of the plane required. Painting checks on a curving cowl takes skill, and it's all done basically by eye. I don't know of anyone better than Nathan in the paint shop at Robin Cos. It just worked, and it's stunning. The only other addition to the plane are hooker harnesses and a G-meter. What followed was a ton of duel with Ivan Davy until he allowed me into the front seat, which is where the only brakes in the plane are. Since then, it's been nothing but 400 hours of fun flying.